Good morning, good morning, good morning, everybody. It is hump day, hey, Wednesday, and it is raining. This weather has been very, very interesting in the state of Texas. I'm telling y'all, like yesterday, the day prior, today, it's nice and cold, and now it's cold and wet. Ew, right? But anywho, we are still alive. We are well on planet Earth, and our Creator is still good. God is still good. Right? So we won't have any complaints today. It's just going to be what it is. And rain is a purifier. And that's one thing that we have to remember. When it begins to rain, something's being purified. And that's what I wanted to talk to you guys about today. Purification. The process of purification. You know, myself, and I'm going to just talk about me, y'all. You know, I don't talk about other people like that. I talk about me in my own ministry. Amen. But purification is a process. To be purified from anything, it takes a process. If you're a diamond, you start off looking very dark and ugly, a lump of coal, if you will, and you have to be dumped into an extremely hot fire, and it takes a process for you to come out shining and perfect as we see diamonds. Flawless, as we say. Some people say, oh, that's a flawless diamond. And the more expensive the diamond is, the less flaws it has. Isn't that interesting? So the more expensive a diamond is, the less flaws it has. If it has a lot of flaws, it wasn't a heavy investment. It didn't cost you much. So when you think about the purification process to become the diamond that you've seen in your imagination, to become this incredible human, it takes a lot of work. It takes a lot of energy. It takes a lot of effort. It takes a lot of forgiveness. It takes a lot of focus. It takes a lot of stamina. It takes a lot of courage to become purified. The process is challenging. The process of stepping away from unhealthy relationships, the process of stepping away from maybe a place that you actually work that you absolutely hate with a passion. I'm talking about, there's some people that are up this morning. They're either in their vehicles or already at the office, and they dreaded the fact that they got up, got dressed, and went to work. They were trying to think about how they were going to call out, what they were going to say. They can't call out, well, I ain't coming in today. Can't do that. So, you know, people were thinking and contemplating about, how can I just not go to this place that I hate so much? There's a process to get out of that. It's called get your resume done stellarly and begin the journey to apply in other organizations. And hopefully you have not had a bunch of infractions to where when you get ready to roll, you won't have a good reference. You got to have a great reference when you're trying to roll to another destination from the workplace. These are all processes to purification. If you got challenges with your loved ones and you got to deal with somebody, whether you want to deal with them or not, and you have to walk in forgiveness, it is a difficult thing to do when the person is difficult. Raise your hand if you agree. Some people are very difficult and hard to deal with, but you are forced to deal with certain individuals, AKA your children, things like that. You know, just different scenarios where you have to deal with somebody and they're your family member. Well, there's a process to their purification and also your purification to be able to deal with them and be at peace with it. There's a process to making certain that you look a particular way every single day. There's a process to that purification. It's a purification to cleanse your skin every day, to get in the house and take a shower. You're purifying. You're constantly purifying. You're cleansing yourself of the day. You're cleansing yourself of whatever transpired when you stepped out of your home. There's a process to that. I shared with somebody yesterday, and I tell my children this all the time. When you come in and you go in your room, never ever get on your bed with the clothes you've had on all day. Don't get on your bed with that. Take them off. Take them off. That's a process to purification. You want your bed to stay pure. We face all kinds of stuff during the day. All kinds of stuff attached itself to our attire. You don't want that in your bed, do you? It's a process to purification. It's called the process of taking off your clothes and getting into bed without having, you know, street stuff on after you showered, of course. You know, we all know that part. But nonetheless, there's a process with that. There's a process to purification. And so oftentimes we forget that we have to go through these processes to get to the place that we know that we want and desire to be. We got to go through the process. Even right now, there's a process to ride through rain and inclement weather. I can't go as fast as I normally go. I can't drive, you know, in the same areas, because some areas in Houston flood very easily. It can be a matter of minutes and the area will be flooded out. There's a process to that. There's a process for me to go around to do what I got to do to get to my my destination this morning. So just different things. There's different processes to purification. There's processes to people who don't actually are not naturally joyful. They're not naturally happy. They're not naturally up and high and bubbly and all that energetic. There's a process to that. And we can't get mad at them during their process. We have to just bless them as they're being processed to their purification. You know, a lot of people don't know this about me, but I used to be extremely bashful, shy, and quiet. I know y'all don't think that's true. I'm telling y'all, it's very true. I was very quiet, very shy, and extremely bashful for a long time. I had had some things that had transpired in my life that traumatized me for years. I just was apprehensive about opening up. And you guys know that I'm a very jovial person, so I used to use jokes to lighten my heavy load, and I didn't want to have to face whatever it was I was dealing with. And so I would, you know, become a hermit and just back off. And so over the years, the process to my purification came when I forgave the offenders that offended me in my yesteryears. When I forgave them and I let those things go, and I started walking in peace and started walking in tranquility and harmony and integrity and all those good things. And I just began to love myself more and give myself more and give myself the energy I needed and the time that I needed and the patience that I needed to have with me. It was a process to my purification. The woman that you guys are witnessing today and enjoying today and experiencing today is not the woman that I was. I just recently, within the last 8 years of being here in Houston, and Houston was my purification place, my place of process for purification. And in the 8 years that I've been here, I have grown so much, I've evolved so much, I've matured so much. And so I'm just grateful for my purification process. We all have to go through a purification process, and we also have to be patient and wear our garment of patience during our purification and not be so critical on ourselves. You know, we got a lot of critics outside, but a lot of times the greatest critic that we have in our lives is the one looking back at us in the mirror every day. And so I just wanted to get on here real quickly, you guys, and talk to you about the process to purification. One of the main steps is forgiveness. And number one is forgiveness. It's to be okay with what has transpired. Make peace with your past and divorce the pain of it. You gotta let that pain go. You'll never experience peace like you wanna experience until you let that pain go. You don't have to carry the pain anymore. You can release that and let that go. So forgiveness is number one. And focus is number two. And faith is number three. Have the faith to believe that you're going to be just fine through your process, and you will come out as pure gold. You'll come out as that gleaming diamond without any blemishes. You'll be of high, high value. And I just wanted to encourage you guys today to be okay with the process. It's not going to be easy, but it definitely will be worth it. I am your consistency coach, Coach P. Coffee Brown, here in the great state of Texas by way of H-Town. Again, you guys, if you're in the area and you want to get at me, please DM me. Let me know you're here. I would love to meet some of my social media friends and connect with you guys and see what I can do to assist you in your journey and your quest to go from good to great. DM me, hit me up, let me know how I can help you and how I can support you. And thank you to everyone who has purchased my book thus far. You can still purchase it on pre-sales up through February 13th. My incredible, incredible team of contributing authors, amazing humans, Jason Thibodeau, Jason Hendrickson, A.D. Roberts, Robert G.G. Malloy, Victoria Jones Dubois, and also Toniel M. Jackson. Just an incredible group of human beings that have come together in this beautiful project, and we share and exchange ideas and thoughts and tell you about our failures and our victories. It is incredible. The project is amazing. It's getting a wonderful, wonderful amount of attention right now, and we're honored and we appreciate and we gratefully, we're so grateful to you guys for taking the journey with us, with me, and I thank y'all so much. My next project, we're working on that right now diligently. We started working on it while we were doing the other project, so I'm excited about being able to introduce that to you guys in the upcoming months. In the meantime, in the in-between time, you can definitely grab my book, and I would love to autograph it for you. So during the pre-sales, I will be autographing books, and I'll be sending them out to you guys, to your several homes. I got the details and specifics from you guys that have purchased thus far. Please text me your address, 832-510-9193, 832-510-9193. I want to be certain that everybody gets their autographed copy of my new book. I will be on tour starting very, very soon, sooner than I anticipated, and I'm excited about that, and I'm humbled and so grateful for everything that's manifesting. Big shout out to our chief editor. I co-edited, but my chief editor did an amazing job with the project, and it gave us both time to really be able to read it and just enjoy the fruits of everyone's labor. It is an incredible book. I am so proud and honored to be spearheading this as the lead anthologist on the project. So with that being said, have an amazing, incredible hump day. You guys in Houston and surrounding areas, please be safe. Check your local news to be certain that if there's any detours or anything, that you don't go in an area that is already experiencing some minor flooding. I love you guys. Be encouraged. And remember, it's okay to be in your process of purification.